Hi, I'm Dr. Sourabh Patwardhan from the Nadi Bhai Hospital and PG Teaching Institute, Sangli, Maharashtra, India. And this is a vlog about a case where I did a primary chop. So let's begin. This is our FECO Training Institute. So we are quite happy to say that we have trained many of our colleagues from India and abroad, and we enjoy doing that. So let's move to the case which I want to show. A very simple case, I would say, but of course no case is simple. There are always few details of maneuvering which are involved. But before I begin, I just notice a well dilated pupil here, and I pause for a moment to see this miraculous structure called zonules. You can see how nicely they are all over 360 degree holding the lens. And apart from our daily routine, I think if we look at these, you know, details in your life, we find these miracles happening all around us. Look at this structure. I think such a amazingly built, you know, support system for the lens. And of course lens itself is a magnificent structure, and we are fortunate that we get this opportunity to operate on this diseased lens. We call it cataract. So we'll start with the case now. Nowadays I use the 22 gauge MVR, which is a bent MVR, for making the side incision. I find it quite helpful because the size of the incision is always the same. So earlier I used to use the 15 degrees side put knife, which was sometimes giving a variably larger side put incision, which used to leak. So this is much better, and I'm going to use a 2.8 keratome. This is a double bevel keratome, so it is sharp on both upside and downside of the bevel. I'm going to use 2% HPMC. This is a dispersive agent, and it's always good to use dispersive agent for coating the endothelium. I know few colleagues use only cohesive viscoelastic during the surgery and like 1 or 1.4% hyaluronate, but it's not going to protect the endothelium. So always used dispersive viscoelastic to coat the endothelium. I start from the Purkinje image. Here I would like to show you again. So let's begin where I start the capsular axis. I just wanted to show you how I begin the capsular axis. Okay, so here we go. So it starts right from the center and of the Purkinje image, and then I raise a 2 mm flap, and then I go around using the rule of center of triangle. You must see my video on rule of center of triangle. I will give you a link to that. It's very useful for doing a very reliable and repeatable rexis using the cystitome. And here goes the hydrodissection. Fluid is pushed under the capsule. Good amount of fluid push is important to get this fluid wave. And if you have noticed, I did a little bit of hydrodelineation also. There goes my FECO probe. And I'm going to do primary chop. I always go in with lower bottle height. If I want to show you that, just I begin. So you can see the bottle height on that left side. So you can see it's 50 centimeters to begin with. So when I enter with 50 centimeters. So patient gets used to that. And then I raise it to 70 centimeters, which is around 50 millimeters of mercury pressure. And patient is quite comfortable with that. Now I want to take a pause here and just show you what I'm planning. So I'm going to use, I'm going to do a primary chop. My settings are 70 centimeters of water, which is around 50 millimeters of mercury pressure. The vacuum, I'm going to use a Venturi system. I'm going to use 250 vacuum here for doing the chop. And I have kept 70% longitudinal FECO power. There is no torsional power used in this mode. and pulse rate of 10 pulses per second and 70% time on. If it is harder grade cataract, I can increase the power, but up to grade 4, this much of power is adequate on the machine that I use, the Constellation. And now what I'm going to do is start here. So when I'm going to do primary chop, my aim is that the tip should reach almost near the end of the nucleus, which is here. And once it crosses that, I'm going to use my left hand to chop. So the depth of a phaco tip buried inside the nucleus is very important. And most times there we hesitate while doing primary chop. So let's see how it happens. There it goes. You can see the tip buried nicely deep inside, and then my left hand just again we'll see how I did it. Okay, let's go slowly over here. Okay, so I begin here, the tip starts going down inside the nucleus, and then there I'm holding, you can see the vacuum over here, I'm holding it at 230-250, and the phaco power now is zero because I already buried my tip. And then I introduce my left hand, which is 1 millimeter Sinsky. It goes towards the phaco tip first, and then there it goes, it starts doing that lateral movement to separate the nucleus and chop the nucleus in two halves. So that's how it is done. This is a nice grade of cataract for beginners to test their chopping abilities, grade 2 cataract, which is the best. And if you don't feel comfortable, you can always go back to stop and chop. Once all the pieces are made, and here I would like to show you what I did. Each piece when I create, so this is also important part of chopping. You can see when I create any piece, now watch here, I am chopping it into two halves, I separate it completely. So you can see the complete separation. So if you don't have complete separation of pieces, what happens is that these pieces are stuck together. And when you go to the quadrant removal, where I'm going to use the bevel tip, bevel of the phaco tip sideways, and that occludes these pieces very quickly, and thus we have much quicker quadrant removal. Now here I'm using basically 100% ozil in a linear manner. You cannot see that because my video is there on the right hand corner, but I'm using 100% linear ozil, 330 vacuum and 100 centimeter bottle height, which is equivalent to around 70 milliliters of pressure. So that's the end of the surgery. You can see I didn't reduce the vacuum for the last piece because I can see the posterior capsule is very, very stable. So just watch this video again and again, and you have to replay to understand how I was doing the chop, what were my parameters. I use only longitudinal phaco power, and this is a very quick coaxial cortex aspiration and IOL placement. So I think it was a very nice case to demonstrate the primary chop, and I would advise you to select this kind of case, grade 2 cataract, to begin your primary chop. And once you get used to it, then you try it in harder as well as softer grade of cataracts. It's always more difficult to do primary chop in softer grade of cataracts, where you may have to use either trench divide method, or you can just hydroprolapse and just phaco aspirate the softer grade of cataract rather than trying to do primary chop. You can see the CCC is nice and circular, covering the optic. And with these newer IOLs, I have found that the role of CCC actually is not much. Practically, we don't need a very geometrically symmetrical capsular axis, but of course if you have it, you can enjoy the beauty of the capsular axis here. So we come to the end of the surgery here, just enjoying the beauty, of nice capsular axis overlapping the optic. So that's it from me. If you like the vlog, do comment, and if you would like to see more such cases with the vlogging format, do write down in comments so I can put up more of such videos in future. Thank you. See you and have a nice day.